On April 11th, 2023, at 1:35 a.m. local time, the single most consistently explosive volcano on the planet, with more than 36 highly explosive eruptions in the last 10,000 years, produced yet another powerful eruption. Occurring at the Shiveluch Volcano in Russia, it represented this volcano's largest eruption in 59 years, as a 1964 eruption it produced was slightly larger. As a section of Shiveluch's lava dome exploded, a sustained plume of ash was ejected to a height of 54,000 feet or 16.5 kilometers, and 10 centimeters or 4 inches thick of ash quickly fell on the populated town of Klyuchi, which is located 45 kilometers southwest of the volcano. Additionally, pyroclastic flows which were generated during this eruption may have traveled as much as 18 or 19 kilometers. As a whole, we know that this paroxysm was a subplanean eruption, as it contained a sustained eruption column which lasted for several hours, but had an eruption plume height of under 20 kilometers. If it had been 20 kilometers or more, it would have been a planean eruption. And if it had been 20 kilometers or more and ejected more than 10 cubic kilometers of tephra, it would have been an ultraplanean eruption. Yet, this eruption was most likely only a low-end VEI-4, which is still large, with my personal estimate suggesting between 0.16 and 0.25 cubic kilometers of tephra was ejected. I based this figure on comparing ash thicknesses at distance to other volcanoes which produced VEI-4 eruptions, and was a pretty close match in terms of ash thickness at various distances to the 2014 eruption of the Kilometer volcano, as the ash from Shiveluch appears to have covered approximately 150,000 square kilometers of land and ocean. Thus, because of the size of this eruption, I have some good news for those of you who live in Kamchatka, northern Russia, Alaska, Canada, or even Hokkaido. You are quite likely to see spectacular sunsets at points during the next week, which include unusual colors, much like seen after the 2022 eruption of Hungatanga-Hunga-Haapai. The reason is due to the sheer amount of sulfur dioxide gas this eruption ejected into the atmosphere, which was likely about 400,000 tons. These sunsets are likely to be unusually bright and vivid, take up larger sections of the sky than typical sunsets, and contain unusual colors typically not seen, such as purple. The reason this occurs is in the atmosphere, much of the sulfur dioxide slowly combines with oxygen and water to produce sulfuric acid. As an aerosol high in the atmosphere, sulfuric acid and other secondary sulfate compounds scatter a larger percentage of incoming light back to Earth, as light now has to pass through more molecules than unusual. Thus, whereas at noon the sky would normally be blue and yellow, orange, and red at sunset, if a layer of volcanic aerosols were present, the sky would be a more persistent red and orange, as other wavelengths had scattered by then. The cause for the high-altitude purple coloration at sunsets after volcanic eruptions relates to already scattered blue light scattering downwards once again at the aerosol layer and combining with red to form the color purple. Such effects are likely to occur in the next 1 to 2 weeks, if at all. However, the hazards from Shiveluch are not yet over, as shown by this volcano, which erupted again just after midnight on April 12, 2023. However, this time the generated eruption plume was in the upper 10% compared to typical eruption plume heights, but was a mere fraction of the eruption size on the prior day. More such smaller eruptions with about the same plume height are likely in the next week. Yet, a more significant danger remains. Everyone in the region needs to stay away from riverbeds within 90 kilometers of Shiveluch's summit, even if they currently appear frozen or dry, as so much molten rock was ejected that this still warm ash is likely to not only melt the snow underneath it, but when the next snow or rain comes, large sections of this fresh ash will be swept away and funneled into natural low points, possibly generating destructive lahars. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.